Hi, I'm Wanda from Go Laser Go, and in this video I'm going to show you the xTool F1 slide extension, and I'm going to tell you everything you need to know to get this awesome accessory up and running. Let's start with a super quick unboxing. So of course you get a manual, and as you can see it's beautifully boxed to keep it well protected during transit. Now we can see the slide extension here, and as with all the xTool products that we've received, it's quite solid and it's beautifully finished. You also get a screwdriver, and you get five clamps. You get two of one sort and three of another, and that's just to hold your projects in place. And we also get a cable and a ruler, and we'll show you how to attach that further on in this video. Now it's time to set it all up. Now, as you can see, underneath the slide extension are some grooves, and these fit perfectly over the base of the machine. So just pop it on the top like that. Now the next thing you're going to do is take your cable and you plug one end into the back of the slide extension and one into the side of your F1 machine. And then you just need to turn on your xTool F1. In the Creative Space software, you need to connect your machine. So just click on the Connect Device option, and then when your machine appears, just select it and it should now be connected. Now we want to calibrate the slide extension, so we start by clicking Laser Extension from the drop-down menu on the right-hand side. And you can see here that the grid is now changed in size, and we also get a pop-up at the top of the screen, and at this point just click Go. And then we'll get another pop-up appear, so let's go through the steps. Now the first thing we want to do is attach the ruler and align it to zero on the slide extension. So just pop it on and then move it across until it lines up with the zero, as you can see here. And once you've aligned it, you can tighten the screw to hold it in place. The next step is to align the slide extension with the second line on the base of the machine. And you can see those lines here. So you just want to drag the slider up to line up with those lines, and it should be like this when it's done. Now we need to move the ruler to the working area, and you do this by just sliding it along until you see the two laser dots appear over the ruler. And now you turn the focus wheel on the side of the machine until those two dots are aligned. Now once that's done, back in the software, you just need to click Next. Now for this step we need to tighten the left and the right screws, but only lightly. So you should already be able to lightly tighten the first one on the left, so go ahead and loosely tighten that, and then we'll move the slider as far as it will go to the left, and you'll see the right hand screw, which you can now loosely tighten. Now back in the software you can click Next, and when you do this you'll notice that the machine automatically moves on its own to the right, so make sure that everything is out of the way at this point. Now when it stops, a blue laser line appears along the white line of the ruler. Now if we come back to the software, we can see that it has taken us to step 3, and it wants us to manually move the slide extension to align it with that blue line. So as you can see here, we're nudging it back and forward to get it to line up nicely. Just take your time with this because you want to get it lined up nicely along that white line. And once you have it all aligned, the software then tells us that we need to tighten the left screw. And you should be able to see that screw, so just tighten it up now. And once you've done that, you just come back to the software and click Next, and the machine will automatically move to the left. And the software jumps to step 4 and tells us to tighten the right screw, and we are doing that now. And once that's done, you can click Complete and your machine is calibrated. Okay, so let's start with our first project, and this was engraving on a long piece of hardwood. And the first thing we need to do is to line up those red and blue laser dots. So again, we turn the focusing wheel on the side of the machine until the two dots merge, like so. And then back in the software, I'm going to click on the text option and type some text. Now you can import an image if you prefer, but as you can see, I'm just selecting my preferred font, and then I'll resize the text to fit my piece of wood. I want to engrave this text, so I click the engrave option from the processing options. And as you can see just below that, you can select the power and speed to suit. But I'm actually going to go with the default setting from the software itself. So I click on the grid and then the side panel changes, and now I can select from the materials option. And I'm going to click more and then click this drop down and select the wood option. And from here, I'm going to select the 3mm basswood plywood option. Now we need to click the framing option so we can see where the text is going to engrave on our piece of wood. So you can see the slide extension moves to the ruler and then stops and displays a frame on the wood. Now obviously this frame is smaller than where we're going to engrave, so in order to see the full framing area, just turn the focus wheel on the side of the machine. The slide extension will move along, and then at some point the framing area will stop, and this indicates where the engraving will end. Now you can repeat this process as many times as you need to get the material in the right position. And then back in the software you can click on stop framing. And now we're ready to engrave, so we can click the process option and you'll see your text or image appear in the preview screen. And then we click start. And then we press the focus wheel button on the side of machine and away it goes. And you can see here it's doing a really, really nice job. I'm very happy with it and do like this font. This font is called Impact and it does a really nice job for something like this. So I'm just going to type our logo or our name of our channel, which is Go Laser Go. And you can see there it's done a beautiful job. Now for our next project, we thought we might try the F1 out on a piece of polonia wood, and this time we not only engraved the text but also cut out around the outside. Now it was our first time using this type of wood, so we weren't too sure about the settings. I think next time we'd adjust the power for the cutting portion as it didn't cut quite cleanly, but overall I think it looks great. We wanted to try out some batch engraving next, so we took 4 MDF coasters and laid them out on the slide extension. And in order to space the coasters evenly, we used a piece of wood that measured 1/4 inch, and you can see that there. And in the software, you can see how we set out the text. Now the file came from Creative Fabrica, and there'll be a link in the description field below for that. You can see how beautifully these are engraving. MDF always makes a lovely job when it comes to engraving. Now they all lined up perfectly, except for the last one, but that was our fault as we didn't line it up in the software correctly. But look at that, isn't that a beautiful job? And you can see here, you can see the last one is slightly down. This next project is a box template that we also got from Creative Fabrica, and this is actually cardstock that we're using here. Now the machine is creating scoring lines which will make it easier to fold the box shape when it's finished. And now you can see it's starting to cut, so we're cutting out the template shape. Now when we turn it over, you'll see that the scoring lines have not gone all the way through, which is exactly what we want. The scoring lines really are just to make it easy to fold the box into shape. And you can see here how easy it is to fold. It's done a lovely job with those scoring lines. And we just keep folding on those lines until we get it all into place. And there you are, that's the box finished. Included in the box are 5 clamps, and these are pretty ingenious as you can use them in a variety of different ways. Now this is clamp 1 and you'll get 2 of these, and as you can see this one is spring loaded, and I'll show you what that does in just a moment. Now with this clamp you can lift up the lever on the side and turn it so that it faces towards your project to hold it in place, and you can see that it locks in place nicely, and you can turn it to the left or the right to suit your project. You'll notice on the bottom of this clamp that there are 2 knobs. Now these fit into the gaps on the slide extension, so you just place it in and slide it along to where you want it, and then just tighten up the screw, and you can see how well that holds. Now you can also slide it into any of the middle gaps as well. Again, just slide it to where you want it and tighten the screw. Here you can see just one example of what you can do with these clamps and how the spring-loaded part works. Now for the first clamp, we just lifted up the lever so that it fits over the piece of wood and then moved it into position. And for the second clamp, we squeezed the spring part of the clamp and moved it along into place. Now the next thing we did was tighten up the screws so that they were nice and firmly tightened, and then you can see just how solidly they hold. This is clamp number two, and you get three of these. Now they work in a different way to clamp one. As you can see, there is a lever on the side and you can move it backwards and forwards just by squeezing against it. Now, like the first clamp that we just went through, this one also allows you to turn the lever to the left or right to suit your project. However, unlike the first clamp, this one doesn't slide on. Instead, you squeeze the lever and you clamp it to the slide extension. And you can see here, it holds nice and solid. And then you take your project and your material, and in this case, we have an MDF coaster, and we place it under the clamp and tighten the screw. And just tighten it until it's firmly in place. And then we place the second clamp in the same way. So there we go, we just press the lever and pop it onto the slide extension. So that's just a couple of ways to use these clamps, and kudos to whoever designed them, as they do a great job. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, because it does help our channel to grow, and we will have more projects for the F1 in the future.